Loving Vincent is the world's first feature-length painting animation film. The filmmakers are reimagining 94 of Vincent Van Gogh's paintings into the medium of film. To do this, they need to paint 66,960 frames of oil paintings. If you laid all of these frames on the ground at the size that they were painted, they would not only cover the whole of London, they would additionally cover the entire island of Manhattan as well. Loving Vincent is a huge and unique undertaking, but it started off as something very personal to one person. Painter and filmmaker Dorota Kobiela wanted to make a film about Vincent's life and paintings because of her personal response to reading his letters and studying his paintings in a time of crisis in her own life. Her short film idea has gone on to become a major international film production. Many people told us a fully painted feature film would be impossible, and we should do it in the computer instead. But Dorota knew it had to be painted to give the right feeling and be as true as possible to both the spirit and to the actual execution of Vincent's work. So, Dorota came up with the idea of separating the painting and the animation process. The movement will be provided by a combination of live action for the actors, combined with visual effects and CG animation. Then we will have specialist oil painters who can concentrate on being faithful to Vincent's brushstrokes and colours. We did a test in 2012.
Everybody rejected
him. The response that we got was so positive that it gave us confidence to try what many people thought impossible. To do the film, we needed to find 80 top-level oil painters who not only painted well enough to faithfully render Vincent's style and not only learn enough animation to follow the underlying material, but could also add the feel and beauty of the movement in the process of applying the paint. The production faces many challenges in translating and reimagining Vincent's paintings into the medium of film. Vincent used different sizes of canvases, whereas for film you can only have one frame size, so for some pictures we have had to extend or change Vincent's framing. Some of the paintings we used were vertical canvases, like Terrace and Observation Deck at the Moulin de Blutfin, Montmartre. Also for this painting, we changed the colours, because Vincent painted it in winter, whereas our film takes place in summer. So we referenced other paintings that he painted in Paris in the summertime, in and around Montmartre, as the basis for the revised palette. There is a lot of variety of styles and techniques across Vincent's paintings, especially as in Paris he was experimenting with new techniques. This created situations when a character from one painting would enter a painting that is done in a different style. This is often the case for our film's hero, Armand Roulant. Our aim was that Armand should, wherever possible, harmonize with the style of the real painting that he is invading. That is why in these shots, you can see Armand is painted slightly differently in each. Inevitably, there were parts of Vincent's life that we needed to show in the film, which he never painted. Dorota therefore came up with the idea of having flashbacks in the film, which would be done in a black and white painted style based on photographs from the era. This freed us up to show many dramatic situations from his life without taking it upon ourselves to imagine up whole series of paintings that never existed. There were instances where we had to imagine new paintings to fill in gaps. For example, we chose the yellow portrait of Postman Roulant as our basis for the postman character in the film because we could set his argument with his son Armand in the famous Café Terrace at night. Here is a frame from the wide shot of Café Terrace at night. As this painting is a vertical painting, we chose to have a camera move taking us from the stars down to the café, so we wouldn't need to change anything in the painting. So far, no need of a new painting. But for an argument, we needed the other person in the argument, Armand. Therefore, we had to imagine what Armand would look like in Cafe Terrace at night. In the scene before, Postman is walking his drunk son to the cafe through Les Alicamps. So we had to change Vincent's painting from autumn day to summer nighttime. Again, we wanted to get close to the action. So we had to imagine how Vincent might have painted Les Alicamps from a different perspective with Postman and Armand in there as well. Vincent's greatest ambition was to paint modern portraits which would convey the soul of the sitter and hope that people could still look upon these portraits in 100 years and get a sense of who that person was. This is why we wanted the audience to be able to see the real people underneath the paintings, see the emotions on their face. We needed to cast actors who had a physical resemblance to the paintings and who could bring the character of that painting to life. Our cast includes Douglas Booth as Armand Roulon, Jerome Flynn as Dr. Gachet, Saoirse Ronan as Margaret Gachet, Helen McCrory as Louise Chevalier, and Aidan Turner as the boatman.